Hello students, as we have seen the meaning of a member, the importance of a member in a company and what are the extra benefits that are being given to a member of a company. So now let us see the rights, duties and the liabilities of a member, right? So rights means what are the rights or what are the facilities or what means एक मेंबर का क्या हक है टुवर्ड्स द कंपनी राइट सो दिस इज द राइट ऑफ अ मेंबर द ड्यूटीज मींस कंपनी के तरफ मेंबर्स की क्या ड्यूटीज बनती है मेंबर्स की क्या रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज होती है दीज ऑल विल कम अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ ड्यूटीज एंड लाइबिलिटीज ऑफ अ मेंबर मीन्स एक मेंबर के ऊपर कंपनी से रिलेटेड क्या लाइबिलिटीज हो सकती है या होनी चाहिए एंड वॉट अ मेंबर इज सपोज टू डू इन दीज केसेस एंड वॉट अ मेंबर इज सपोज टू एक्ट इन दीज सिचुएशन सो Let us see one by one what are the rights and duties and then later on we'll study the liabilities of a member. Now, first we'll see the rights and the duties, the rights of the members. The first is the right of accessing books and documents. Whatever important books and documents are there in an organization, those books and documents and paperwork and files are accessible to all the members. All the members can check. The documents can see the documents, whatever things are written in that, what are the clauses, what are the rules mentioned in those books, right? Why? Because a member is the person who have invested their money into that. And jahan par humne hamara paisa lagaya hai, wahan we have the right to see the documentation ki hamara paisa kahan use ho raha hai and how our money is invested or used by the company and the management. So some of the examples of books or files that are accessible to the members are the memorandum of association, articles of association, auditors report, right, books of accounts. So these are some of the documents. Now what is memorandum of association? Memorandum of association is the primary, is the supreme and the most important document of any of the company. Without memorandum, any company cannot be formed. For the formation of a company, we need to register ourselves with the help of these document that is known as memorandum of association. Now, in the memorandum of association, the formation of a company, the aims and objectives of a company, with what amount of capital was the company started, who were the first directors of a company, who was the first auditor or the secretary of a company. So all the important things related to the company, the date of incorporation of the company, when was the company formed. So all these important things related to the company's formation and startup of the company is mentioned in the memorandum of association, and that is why this document is very important. So any member has the right and he and the authority to check the memorandum of association. The second most important document is articles of association. It is the secondary and the subordinate and the second most important document. Articles of association is also important for any company to form and register itself. So in articles of association, the internal management of the company is mentioned. Now what do you mean by internal management? Internal management means the form, the working of a company. How does the company work? What are the functions of a company? How is the role given to each and every employee or important official in a company? So what will be the duties of managing director? What will be the duties of CEO? What will be the functions of CS, auditors and CAs? When for what period they will be appointed in the company? What will be their role? What will be their rights? Because some private companies, some basic rules and regulations can be a little or slightly different from a public company. So in every article of association, there means every company who is making articles of association, those companies have to mention what is the role of different kinds of people in an organization, how the company is going to work. So it is very easier and it is very accessible to all the employees. So whoever sometimes is not available with the rules and the working of a company, some new officials are appointed. So it is like a guidebook to the people for following the rules, because it is not possible altogether to keep in mind all the rules and regulations of the company. So if the rules are mentioned in a book, that is Articles of Association, so it can act as a rule book which the people can refer while working in an organization. Articles of Association can have its copy, because in its the working of a company is written. So 2 or 3 or 5 or 6 copies can be made, and it can be distributed to each HODs or managers or important people, so that if the employees want to refer it, they can go through it. But and articles is only for the internal people of the company, means कंपनी का फंक्शनिंग है, तो डेफिनेटली कंपनी में काम करने के लिए सिर्फ एम्प्लॉयज एंड मैनेजमेंट ही आएंगे. सो ओनली दोज पीपल आर अलाउड टू सी इट अदर देन द मेंबर्स. नाउ मेमोरेंडम ऑफ एसोसिएशन इज द डॉक्यूमेंट व्हिच can be referred by the outside people also, and also the members are also allowed to see it. Then the balance sheet, which the final balance sheet is made and it is audited by the auditor. So the auditor makes the report on the basis of the balance sheet or the entries that are being made by the accountant, right? So when the CA or the auditor does the auditing, so in that case he makes auditor report, and based on that the final profit and the final investments are decided in a meeting, and then the dividend is distributed to the shareholders or the members of the company. Done. Now, inspection of registers of members. There is a register of member that is being maintained by every company. So each and every member who is becoming the member in an organization, and he and when he is leaving, his name is removed from the register of members, and the new members who are joining the company, those names are updated now and then as they are joining the company. So this important document can be seen by any of the member whenever they want to see it or refer it. Then debenture holders, the debentures. What do you mean by debentures? Debentures are a short-term loans that are being given by the company to the people. Right, when the company is in need of some money, so this type of facility, debentures, is given by the company to the people, so that the people can purchase the debentures. That means that is nothing a short term loan that that the people are giving to the company. Right, so if I am a company, for example XYZ, so if the company is in need of money, the company will issue the debentures to the people, and those people will purchase the debentures. That means they are giving the loans to the company. So in that debenture certificate, it will be mentioned for how much time the company is taking the loan, for example 2 years, on what rate of interest the company will return the money, for example 9%, right? So this is the thing on how the company issues the debentures to the people. That means the people are allowing the company to borrow money from them and then returning it after a certain period of time with a good amount of interest. Right, now these debenture holders are also their names are mentioned and maintained in a register, so that register can also be seen by the members. Then charges are the interest whether the company is giving, for example debenture holders, bond holders, right? And or if the company has to take it from someone or give it from someone, so whatever interest is related to any type of loans, whether the company is giving or taking, those interest can also be seen by the members, and again it is mentioned in a register or in a file so that the people can members can be easily accessible to it. Now, what are investments? Investments are something which the company does investments or engage their money into some other businesses, into some other land property, into some other infrastructures or shares. So, company also does investments in case in future emergencies. So, whenever in the future the company needs the money, so that company can use these investments and take the money out of it. Then minutes book. What is minutes book? Minutes are the recordings of the meetings that are being held in an organization. So jitni bhi meetings a company mein hoti hai, unka minutes book maintain kiya jata hai. Matlab मीटिंग में किसने क्या बोला, मीटिंग कब थी, कौन से डेट पर थी, क्या टाइम था, क्या वेन्यू था, किस टॉपिक पर मीटिंग थी, क्या डिसाइड हुआ उस मीटिंग में, कौन सा वोटिंग टाइप्स यूज किया गया है. सो ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर मेंशन इन अ मिनट्स बुक इन केस वी वांट टू रेफर इट इन द फ्यूचर और इफ यू वांट टू चेक वेदर व्हाट वी हैव डिसाइडेड इन द लास्ट मीटिंग. सो थ्रू मिनट्स बुक वी कैन सी इट एंड वी कैन चेक इट एंड ऑल्सो द मिनट बुक एक्ट्स एज अ प्रूफ दैट वी हैव कंडक्टेड द मीटिंग बिकॉज according to companies act, according to the government, it is important for every joint stock company to held a meeting, many meetings actually. So those are also an evidence for the government to give them as an evidence. Now the next is proxies. What are proxies? Proxies are the people who comes in the exchange of some other person. For example, in school, proxies you have heard the term proxies. In some second period or third period, if the teacher is not coming, so some other teacher comes and takes the class, or she comes in the class and teaches you. So that is a proxy. When a person is not available, in exchange of that person, some another person come. So when the members are not available to attend any of the meeting, so they can send in exchange of them or in behalf of them or as a representative of them any person who will attend the meeting. So that person is known as proxies. Only the members are allowed to send the proxies, and also for proxies also we have many conditions and many rules which we will study in further topics. And the last is returns. Returns is taxes. So whatever taxes company has paid, whatever fines company was implied by the government, so all these things are also allowed to the members to keep a check. The next point is right to make fundamental corporate decision. Means the important corporate means company's decision to take any important decision for the company. So a member also has right to speak on the topic and suggest for the betterment of the company. So the first is change of registered office of a company. Every company, when it is forming, when it is getting registered, it has to give the government a registered office from where the company will be working in the future. So for that reason, change of if the company is changing the registered office of the company, then it has to inform the government, and then only it can change the registered address of the office. So for that reason, first they have to decide, first they have to take the permission from the members, then they have to inform the government, and then they can change the registered address of the office. The next is increase in authorized capital. What is authorized capital? We have heard share capital, we have heard capital. Capital is the money that is being invested in a company to start the company and to run the company. Now, what is share capital? The capital which is divided into small number of units in the form of shares, and it is distributed to the people and shareholders, and then they purchase it. So that is known as share capital. The authorized capital means the maximum amount of capital the company is allowed to give to the people, to give to the shareholders in the form of shares, not shareholders, to the investors in the form of shares. That means एक कंपनी के पास मैक्सिमम कितना रुपए है. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर मैंने कंपनी में 2 लाख रुपीज लगाए तो मैं 5 लाख रुपीज के शेयर्स नहीं दे सकती हूँ. मेरा लिमिट अप टू 2 लाख ही रहेगा जितना मैंने कंपनी में लगाया है. सो ऑथोराइज कैपिटल मीन्स अथॉरिटी ऑफ अ कंपनी और द मैक्सिमम अमाउंट ऑफ फॉर अ कंपनी so that the company can distribute the shares, the company can divide the shares and give it to the investors for the investments. So authorized capital in short is the maximum amount of money, maximum amount of company that the maximum amount of capital that a company is allowed to give in the form of shares to the people who purchase it, right? Now, if we have to increase our amount of authorized capital, so we have to again, there is a long process for that, and first we have to take the permission, and our members are also, they have a right to give their decision on this. Now, change of objects of a company. Objects is objective. Once you have registered your company with an objective, for example, if I want to start my business for shoe manufacturing, so I cannot change my objective. I have to manufacture shoes only. But there is a condition, there is a situation which the government allows you to change your objective of a company, and for that, first we need to take the permission from members, and then we can apply for that. Next is amend. Amend means changes. तो articles of association में अगर हमें changes करना है, उसके लिए भी we need to take the permission from the members. And only articles of association can be changed. Why? Because articles में सिर्फ rules लिखे होते हैं. तो rules तो company के कितने बार भी बदल सकते हैं. जैसे ही government ने अपनी policy update की, जैसे ही government ने अपने rules update किए, तो similarly उसी time पर हमें हमारे articles में भी changes लाने पड़ते हैं. क्योंकि government हमेशा अपडेट करती है अपने लॉस को, और आपको भी आपकी कंपनी अपडेटेड रखनी है. फॉर दैट रीजन यू नीड टू चेंज द रूल्स आल्सो इन द आर्टिकल्स. बट अ मेमोरेंडम ऑफ एसोसिएशन नेवर चेंजेस. क्यों? क्योंकि आपकी कंपनी फॉर्म हो गई है, राइट? तो मेमोरेंडम ऑफ एसोसिएशन में कंपनी का फॉर्मेशन, कंपनी के ऑब्जेक्टिव्स लिखे होते हैं, राइट? तो वो चीज फॉर्म हो गई है, वो अब नहीं बदल सकती, राइट? सो फॉर दैट रीजन आप मेमोरेंडम को नहीं बदल सकते. इट इज अनऑल्टरेबल डॉक्यूमेंट, बट आर्टिकल्स ऑफ एसोसिएशन को आप बदल सकते हैं. नेक्स्ट इज एक्विजिशन, मर्जर्स एंड टेक ओवर्स. एक्विजिशन मतलब जब कंपनी किसी को एक्वायर करना चाहती है बिकॉज ऑफ स्ट्रॉन्ग फाइनेंशियल कंडीशन और एनीथिंग. मर्जर्स मींस जब दो कंपनी मर्ज हो जाती है, आप मींस दोनों कंपनी की सहमति से. एंड टेक ओवर मींस जब एक कंपनी बहुत लॉस में है या वीक है, एंड द सेकेंड कंपनी टेक्स ओवर इट, एंड ऑल द थिंग्स रिलेटेड टू द एम्प्लॉयज वर्किंग, रिलेटेड टू द मशीनरीज एंड एवरीथिंग वो टेक ओवर कर लेते हैं. सो इन शॉर्ट तीनों का एक बेसिक मतलब होता है व्हेन टू कंपनीज कंबाइन. तो जब अगर किसी भी कंपनी के साथ हमें काम करना है, उसको टेक ओवर करना है, उसको खरीद लेना है, उसके साथ मिलके काम करना है, सो फॉर दैट रीजन आल्सो वी नीड द परमिशन ऑफ मेंबर्स. द नेक्स्ट इज अपॉइंट सोल सेलिंग एजेंट्स. सोल सेलिंग एजेंट्स आर दोज एजेंट्स विच द कंपनी hires so that in a particular region of a city the agents can supply our products to the local shopkeepers or the supermarkets, right? For example, Nagpur is a very big place, so there are different places, right? There is this colony, there is Birdi, there is Dharampet. So if I want to deliver my product to all those things, all those means all over the city. So it is not possible for me to supply everything, right, to roam in every other shop of Nagpur. So for that reason, a company hires sole selling agent. Sole selling agent, sole means single. Selling agents मतलब agents means type of brokers or agents and selling मतलब जो हमें बेचने में help out करते हैं. So हमारे product को if I want to reach out to a certain place, so मैं उस area के लिए एक sole selling agent appoint कर लूँगी and उस area में उस agent के अलावा कोई और मेरे products नहीं बेच सकता, right? So the company appoints many different agents for a different different areas of a city, and only those agents are responsible for the distribution and the selling and the advertising and the delivery of the products in that area. And simultaneously, for a company also, it is very convenient to keep a check on only one person for a certain area. So to keep the record, to maintain the record, it is also very important. So that decision is again, the members have the right to speak in that decision making. And the last is winding up of a company. Winding up मतलब जब company को हमें बंद करना है, right? So जिसका पैसा लगा है, so members का पैसा लगा है, so for that reason we if the board of directors or the managing committee decides to wind up the company with because of any reason, so in that situation the management will definitely ask the members, and the members have the right to ask, to question, and to see whether the company is really in need of winding up or it can move on further. The next is right to participate in general meeting. What is general meeting? Meetings, any meeting means in an organization, anything which we want to decide is through meeting only. Because in a joint stock company, there are many people whom for whom decision is very important. Decision taking, we have to ask different people. Because joint stock companies, again, the collaboration, the joining of many people all together, their money, their time, their skills. So that for that reason, we need to ask many people for taking any decision. So anything that is decided in a joint stock company, it is done with the help of meetings. So the members have some rights related to these types of meetings. So the first is right to receive notice and agenda. What is notice? Notice is the type of a invitation in which every details for the meeting is written. What is the topic? What is the venue for the meeting? What will be the time? What will be the place? Right, who are the people who are invited, if there are some people who are not coming and they are sending their proxy, so all those things are written in the notice so that the people would come to know about the meeting and they will come. What is agenda? Agenda is the topic of a meeting. Jis topic par hame baat karni hai and jis topic par hame decision lena hai. So that thing is the agenda. So for invitation of the notice of the meeting, we send a notice along with the copy of agenda attached together to the people, to the members, to the shareholders, to the directors, so that they would read the notice and they would come to the to attend the meeting. The next is attend general meeting in person or appoint proxy. So every member have a right to attend the general any type of meeting in person, means personally, and or appoint proxy. Or agar wo nahi aa sakte to unke behalf pe proxy. What is the need of proxy? Because ek vote us member ka waste na ho, aur jo bhi means for or against, जो भी उसको decision लेना है, so he can tell the proxy that I want to do this in the company, and accordingly the proxy can vote. Next is speak and vote at the meetings. To speak and to vote at the meetings, this is the right of the members, not proxy. Proxy is not allowed to keep his opinion in the meeting. He is just there to vote in the meeting, right? to demand and vote at a poll. Demand means poll is a type of voting method that is very important, that is very legally that is considered correct in the eyes of law, and when the decision is taken by the poll method, means the voting of the poll method, that decision is considered as final. So that is the reason poll method is taken. Otherwise, there are more options of voting at a meeting, right? So those methods can also be taken into consideration, but when the poll method is demanded, it is a very important method of voting, and it is considered legal in the eyes of law, and that is more trustworthy type of voting method. And poll method is, the decision by poll method is considered as final. So every member have the right to demand firstly the poll method and to vote at a poll method. And the last is demand to call an AGM. Every member have the right to demand for an EGM. What is EGM? Extraordinary General Meeting. Extraordinary General Meeting is a type of a meeting which is demanded or which is organized for a very special event, for very urgent event or very important event, right? For example, if there is a death of very important person in a company, for example, if a few years back there was demonetization, so definitely it affected the business. So every important decision and actually important and urgent situations, special in situations which is not into the daily routine of a company. So to decide those special events, to decide those important and urgent matters, an extraordinary general meeting is organized, and to demand that EGM, any member is have the right to call for it. The next is right to appoint and remove a director. Every member, being the investor, being the shareholder, being the owner of a company, they have the right to appoint and to remove a director, right? वो directors को appoint भी कर सकते हैं, and अगर वो देख रहे हैं, observe कर रहे हैं कि किसी भी director का performance अच्छा नहीं है, या फिर वो कोई frauds activities में है involved, या फिर वो अपने power का बहुत ज़्यादा misuse कर रहे हैं, so in that case, every members with their voting can remove a director also. The next is right with respect to company's accounts and audits. Company ke accounts and audits mein members ka kya role hai? Let us see. The first is approve annual accounts at an annual general meeting. Annual general meeting is a meeting which in a year is taken once every year to decide the dividend of a company. Ki is saal company ko kitna profit hua and wo profit hum kaise kaise use karenge. And every AGM में सारे members, shareholders का होना भी important होता है. So the members approve the annual account, means after the auditing of the auditors, they check कि what are the expenses by the company, what are the investments by the company, कितना interest दिया है company ने, कितना profit earn किया है, so all these things they can check. Appoint auditors, they can appoint auditors, means CAs, to do the auditing in the company. Decide their remuneration. Decide their remuneration. What will be their remuneration? It will be like a fees, like honorary, or it will be like percentage in profit sharing. So whatever be the manner, the management or the members decide that. The next is right to remove auditors. If their auditors, if some of the auditors, they are not comfortable with their work, is not up to the mark, so they can also remove the auditor. So these are all the rights of the members. The next is right to participate in the profits of a company. The members have the right to approve dividend. जितना management ने, जितना auditor ने profit निकाला है, उसमें का कितना percent dividend उन members को देना चाहिए, उनको जाएगा, कितना percentage जाएगा, उसका right भी members के पास होता है, क्योंकि ultimately they are the owners, उनने पैसा लगाया है, तो उसका return किस form में होना चाहिए, that decision is also made by the members. एंड गेट इट विद इन 30 days ऑफ इट्स डिक्लेरेशन एट द एजीएम. और एनुअल जनरल मीटिंग में जो जो भी परसेंटेज डिसाइड हो गया, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन इन एन एजीएम इट इज बींग डिसाइडेड दैट 12% प्रॉफिट विल बी डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अमंग्स द members in the form of dividend. So within 1 month or within 30 days that dividend should be declared, means that should be given to the members in person or otherwise in through the couriers or through the money orders and something. So they have the right to take or demand the money in 1 month after the meeting. The next is shareholding rights. Right to receive share certificate, definitely they are the owners, they have invested the money, they are the shareholders. So if they want the proof ki they are the owners of that company, and that is the reason they want the share certificate. Share certificate is the proof that you have purchased the shares in that company. Then transfer of shares. If I do not want to continue with the company, I can transfer my shares to any person. Right, with my will, मेरी मर्जी से मैं transfer कर रही हूँ shares को, and then जैसे ही वो पूरे पैसे दे देगा मुझे, so the ownership will be transferred, my ownership will be transferred on his name, right? So that is the transfer of shares. तो वो भी जब भी मुझे नहीं continue करना है company के साथ, I can sell it to anyone. In public company, private company have some restrictions upon this. Next is to get the rights issue. Rights issue is the asking of a company to its existing shareholders that whatever shares, new shares are being introduced by the company, you want to purchase it or not, right? For example, जैसे कोई भी चीज, जैसे कंपनी में नए शेयर्स आते हैं, राइट? सो अदर देन इंट्रोड्यूसिंग टू द आउटसाइडर्स, फर्स्ट कंपनी अपने जो ऑलरेडी एग्जिस्टिंग, मतलब ऑलरेडी जो कंपनी के शेयर होल्डर्स हैं, उनको पहले ऑफर करती हैं. अगर वो कोई शेयर होल्डर परचेज करते हैं या नहीं करते हैं, तो फिर जो शेयर्स बचते हैं वो हम आउटसाइडर्स को फिर अप्रोच करते हैं. अदरवाइज कंपनी सबसे पहले अपने जो शेयर होल्डर्स ऑलरेडी हैं उनको पहले वो चीज ऑफर करती है. सो दैट इज राइट्स इशू. एंड बोनस इशू मींस द कंपनी, जब कंपनी बहुत ज्यादा प्रॉफिट अर्न कर लेती है, या फिर इन दिवाली या फिर इन नवरात्रि और इन क्रिसमस, द कंपनी ऑफर सम एक्स्ट्रा शेयर्स फ्री ऑफ कॉस्ट टू द शेयर होल्डर्स एज अ बोनस, राइट? जैसे एम्प्लॉयज को बोनस मिलता है अलॉन्ग विद द सैलरी, वैसे ही शेयर होल्डर्स को भी अलॉन्ग विद द डिविडेंड फ्री ऑफ शेयर्स दिए जाते हैं एज अ गिफ्ट, जहां पे शेयर होल्डर्स को उसके लिए पे नहीं करना पड़ता, लेकिन उसका डिविडेंड शेयर होल्डर्स को मिलेगा फ्रॉम द नेक्स्ट टाइम ऑनवर्ड्स. द नेक्स्ट इज राइट टू रिसीव सरप्लस असेट्स. सरप्लस मतलब एक्स्ट्रा, असेट्स मतलब कंपनी के ओन असेट्स, राइट, जो कंपनी ओन करती है. तो जब कंपनी वाइंड अप होगी, जब कंपनी बंद हो जाएगी, राइट, तो जो उसके सरप्लस असेट्स है, जो पैसा बचा हुआ है, जो चीजें बचती है, मशीनरीज और सब फर्नीचर और ये सब, सो इन सब में कुछ ना कुछ पार्टीशन मेंबर्स को मिलना चाहिए. बट आफ्टर गिविंग इट टू ऑल द स्टेक होल्डर्स. व्हाट इज स्टेक होल्डर्स? Stakeholders are those people who are in some other way related to the company, जिनका company से कुछ interest बनता है, company से कुछ फायदा बनता है, जैसे creditors हो गए, debenture holders हो गए, banks हो गए, insurance company, उनकी policy हो गई, तो ये सारी चीजें जो है वो company से इन लोगों का कुछ ना कुछ पैसा बनता है. तो जब company wind up होती है, the company needs to clear all their balances. तो जैसे ही company इन सबके balances clear out कर देती है, फिर जो पैसा बचता है वो, दैट पैसा इज डिस्ट्रीब्यूटेड अमंग्स द मेंबर्स और द शेयर होल्डर्स ऑफ अ कंपनी. सो दैट इज द राइट ऑफ द मेंबर्स टू टेक द एक्स्ट्रा मनी व्हिच इज लेफ्ट आउट व्हेन द कंपनी शट्स डाउन. द नेक्स्ट इज राइट टू क्लास एक्शन सूट. राइट, दिस इज अ टाइप ऑफ एक्ट which is as a very important right given to the members by the company, by the government, right? सो लेट अस सी व्हाट इज इट. राइट टू एक्शन अगेंस्ट द कंपनी और डायरेक्टर्स, ये कब होगा? ये तब होगा जब मेंबर्स को ऐसा फील होगा कि कंपनी और द डायरेक्टर्स एंड द मैनेजमेंट आर डूइंग समथिंग फ्रॉड एक्टिविटीज इन द कंपनी, जिसकी वजह से कंपनी को प्रॉफिट में फर्क हो रहा है, जिसकी वजह से कंपनी के फंक्शनिंग में फर्क हो रहा है, कंपनी की गुडविल अफेक्ट हो रही है. सो दैट इज द रीजन जहां पे कंपनी के अगेंस्ट और डायरेक्टर्स के अगेंस्ट, क्योंकि डायरेक्टर्स कंपनी का मैनेजमेंट संभाल रहे, सो डायरेक्टर्स के अगेंस्ट भी मेंबर्स क्या कर सकते हैं, केस कर सकते हैं या फिर एक्शन ले सकते हैं. राइट, बट किस वे से वो चीज कैरी आउट होगी? सो एनी 100 मेंबर्स और 10% ऑफ वोटिंग राइट्स जिस मेंबर के पास है वो ट्रिब्यूनल में रिड्रेसल के लिए अप्लाई कर सकते हैं. राइट, सबसे पहले देयर आर थ्री इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स इन दिस पॉइंट, वी विल ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड इट वन बाय वन. द फर्स्ट इज 100 मेंबर्स. राइट, सो जितने भी शेयर होल्डर्स है मेरे पास, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इफ द कंपनी इज हैविंग 1000 शेयर होल्डर्स, तो उसमें के 100 मेंबर्स कंपनी के अगेंस्ट एक्शन लेने के लिए तैयार होने चाहिए. दिस इज द फर्स्ट कंडीशन. अगर 100 मेंबर्स नहीं होते तो जितने भी शेयर होल्डर्स है उनके अलावा 10% ऑफ वोटिंग राइट्स वाले शेयर होल्डर्स होने चाहिए. जैसे अर्लियर आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन इन द जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी द वोटिंग और द डिसीजन मेकिंग इज अ कैपिटलिस्टिक वे, मींस पैसे पे डिपेंड करता है, आपके इन्वेस्टमेंट पे डिपेंड करता है कि आपके पास कितना ज्यादा कंपनी की ओनरशिप है एंड वोटिंग राइट्स है. राइट, जैसे 10 लोग हैं, 10 लोगों ने 50-50 के शेयर्स लिए और मैंने 10,000 के शेयर्स लिए, सो डेफिनेटली मेरा डिसीजन ज्यादा कंसीडर किया जाएगा, मेरा जो भी ओपिनियन दूंगी वो ज्यादा कंसीडर किया जाएगा, मेरे पास ज्यादा राइट्स होंगे रादर देन दोस 10 पीपल. डन, सो दिस इज द केस इन जॉइंट स्टॉक कंपनी. सो या तो आप 100 मेंबर्स को रेडी करो कंपनी के अगेंस्ट कुछ, अगर कंपनी कुछ गलत कर रही है तो उनके अगेंस्ट एक्शन लेने, या तो फिर जितने भी शेयर होल्डर्स है उनमें से इतने शेयर होल्डर्स चूज करो जिनका, जिनके पास पावर कंपनी के 100% में से 10% वोटिंग राइट का पावर है, तो उतने शेयर होल्डर्स को लो एंड दे कैन अप्लाई टू द ट्रिब्यूनल. ट्रिब्यूनल इज नेशनल कंपनी लॉ ट्रिब्यूनल. नेशनल कंपनी लॉ ट्रिब्यूनल इज अ टाइप ऑफ अ स्मॉल कोर्ट वी कैन से फॉर द कंपनीज रिड्रेसिंग मींस सॉल्विंग द प्रॉब्लम्स. राइट, फॉर द कंपनीज प्रॉब्लम्स, कंपनी के इश्यूज को सॉल्व करें, जैसे हमारा लोकल कोर्ट्स होते हैं, फिर हाई कोर्ट्स होते हैं, उसी तरीके से एनसीएलटी और एनसीएलएटी होता है, विल स्टडी दैट इन द लेटर चैप्टर्स. तो ये दो टाइप्स के कोर्ट्स, एक्चुअली इट्स अ टाइप ऑफ कमिटीज जो दो चार इंपॉर्टेंट लोग बैठते हैं कंपनी के प्रॉब्लम्स, कंपनी के इश्यूज सॉल्व करने के लिए. कभी मैनेजमेंट और मेंबर्स में प्रॉब्लम होती है, कभी कंपनी और मैनेजमेंट में प्रॉब्लम्स होती है, कभी एम्प्लॉयज और डायरेक्टर्स में प्रॉब्लम होती है. तो जितने भी कंपनी के इश्यूज है वो हमारा, वो ये इंस्टीट्यूट दैट इज नेशनल कंपनी लॉ ट्रिब्यूनल सॉल्व करते हैं, एंड दैट इज वाई ये वहां पर जा सकते हैं एंड दे कैन फाइल अ कंप्लेन अगेंस्ट दैट. एंड एनसीएलटी एक्ट्स जस्ट लाइक अ कोर्ट फॉर द कंपनी एंड द पीपल. The last is the members can demand investigation and can file petition to wind up. वो investigation के लिए demand कर सकते हैं tribunal के officers को, और वो company को बंद करने का भी petition file up कर सकते हैं अगर directors and management is not considering the opinions of the members. So they can file the petition also against the company to wind up, to close or shut down the company. Done. Now let us see the duties and the liabilities of a member. Right? क्या duties members की बनती है और क्या liabilities बनती है? So the members are bound to the company by all the contents of the articles of association. Means the members have to follow each and every rules written in the articles of association and of a company. Articles mein jitne rules diye hai, all the members have to follow that. They have to work according to that. Kuch bhi ek bhi step ya ek bhi act done by the members should not be against the articles of association. And liabilities, if the members are having limited, if the limited liability is the feature of that company, so the member is bound to pay that amount of which the shares they have purchased, because that is the limited liability. Agar maine 5000 ki shares li, to I am responsible, I am liable to pay the company 5000. बट इन केस ऑफ अनलिमिटेड कंपनी जितना भी कंपनी को डेट्स आता है वो सारा के सारा डेट्स क्लियर करने की रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी उन मेंबर्स की होती है बिकॉज योर कंपनी इज एन अनलिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी विद अ फीचर ऑफ अनलिमिटेड लाइबिलिटी सो यू हैव टू फॉलो दैट एंड यू हैव टू हेल्प आउट द कंपनी इन एवरी डेट क्लियरिंग ऑफ इट्स डेट्स सो दीज आर ओनली द foundations and the liabilities and the duties of the members of a company. Thank you.